And say welcome to Jose Manuel Ortega with Ethical Hacking with Python Tools.
Good morning, thank you for coming. Well, this talk is for commenting the main tools that we have in Python ecosystem for obtaining information for servers that is pulling information in internet. Well, this talk is available in my speaker in Spain, where I have another presentation relating with scraping, mobile security, and so on. These are the main points I will talk. I will make an introduction to Python pen testing, what are the main tools that we have. We will comment in the main modules, like sockets, requests, beautiful soup, and shun for obtaining information for public servers. Later, I will mention how to extract metadata for documents and image. And finally, more advanced tools like port scanning and how to connect with scanner vulnerabilities. And finally, I will show a little proof of concepts where I have integrated all these modules in a pen testing tool. Well, Python presenting, a little introduction. Well, Python is very useful for making rapid prototypes and proof of concepts. And many of the tools that we have in for testing security in database and web applications are made with Python. And the main other of the advantages that we have is that they are very good documentation in internet for all these tools that I will comment. Well, for example, two of the main tools that we have for testing application, for example, SQL Map for testing SQL injection vulnerabilities, and Social Engineering Toolkit. These tools are made with Python. And we have another tools like Sparta. Sparta is a port scanning that use Python NMAP. Python NMAP is another tool that I will comment after for checking the ports that are open in a specific domain, server, or application. Basically, with this tool, we can check the service that are open and make a process launch a brute force process over a specific service and so on. Another of the tools that we have that are interesting for analyzing is the Harvester. It's a tool for obtaining information, public information, from the. This tool is you can use for obtaining information about the domains, email accounts, and domains for a specific URL or server. And another very new tool is the Web Application Attack and Unity Framework. This is another tool made with Python. This is very used for auditing web security and detecting vulnerabilities, SQL injection, cross-scripting, and so on. And another tools that we have, for example, SCAPI for analyzing network packets. And for example, if we want to detecting some attacks, SQL injection, you can use these tools. Another tool, for example, another other tools that we have is FIMAP, for example, for detecting remote file inclusion vulnerabilities. All these tools that I have commented are made in Python, and well, I will show the main modules that we can use for developing our tools for testing the security of the servers and web applications. Well, the first proof of concept that we can see is sockets. With sockets, with sockets module, basically we can do is checking the basically Borg scan. With ConnectX method, we can check in a specific port if the method, if the port is open, filter or close in a easy way. This is the most simple program that we can write. Basically, what we do is a question to the user the IP of the IP of the server, and a starting port number and an ending port number, and with a for loop simple we check if the port is open, close or filter. The difference in between, for example, in the close and filter is the filter is the port is filter where it's blocked by a firewall, for example. Sockets allows also obtain information resolving the IP address from the domain and vice versa with the methods gethost by address and gethost my name. We can obtain this information with the sockets module. Also we can check we can obtain the banner service. The banner service is information related with the name of the version of the server, of the web server, for example. And in an easy way, we can check, for example, this is a script where we pass as parameter the IP address and the port and returns information about the server. In this case, we see that it returns that the domain Europython 2016 has an NGINX server. Well, another of the modules very now for all Python developers is request. Request is a very useful module for making for testing web service, API REST, and so on. And basically, what we can do for testing the security of a site, for example. We can check, for example, the headers of the request and the response in an easy way. Accessing to the headers property and iterating over the items dictionary, we can obtain this information. For example, if we check over the Europython site, we see that obtain this information, an NGINX server, and also we see another headers like cookies, the user agent, and so on. Another interesting feature that we can make with requests is, for example, is where behind a proxy for making requests, we can use a proxy dictionary. Where we indicate the HTTP or HTTPS proxy, and in a way we can check the connection behind a proxy with request. And another interesting feature is with request we can authenticate we have a server that supports basic or DIES authentication. We can check this information. We can check the security of this server with the methods HTTP DGS and the basic. Well, another of the tools that we have very now in for web scrapping, for example, is Beautiful Soup. Beautiful Soup is a parser HTML. Basically, what it does is that it's extracting information from a specific tags that we extract. That firstly, we use request for obtain the page, and with the method final, we recover the information. In this case, we recover the links. A more advanced program where we extract the internal and external links. Internal links basically consists in following all links that begin with a slash. And for external links, we try to find all links that start with HTTP or HTTPS that not contain the current URL. In this example, we can see that we extract the externals and internal links. The external links go to an external page that not is the same domain, that is not in the domain that we are testing. And internal links go to pages in the internal domain. Another interesting feature, for example, is we want to extract image and PDF documents. We can use a specific parser. Beautiful Soup has two or three parsers. We have seen the LXML parser, and in this case we are using the HTML parser for where we are using SPAD expressions for extracting the element that we want to extract, in this case image and PDFs. Well, another interesting tool that we have in Python ecosystem very used is Scrapy. Scrapy is for developing. We can use for developing our web spiders, web crawlers, and well, it's very useful for obtain the information for web service and URLs. And this tool use Twisted. Twisted is is a tool for making asynchronous calls and follow the event-driven development paradigm for making these calls to the in asynchronous mode. Well, for starting with Shodan, Shodan basically is a very useful tool for obtain public information that are available in internet. Shodan, what is that? Is obtain the banners and of the servers, operating systems, the versions, the server types, and so on. And basically, what is provides a developer API for, in this case, for Python developers, and in a nice way you can connect with this service through a API, Shodan API key that provides when you register in the site, you get an API key, and with this API key, you can search. We can make the same search, that means the same search that we can do in the web, you can do with the Python API. In this case, we can see that we look. An information for a specific host, and we obtain the ports that are open, returns the banners or the server, the information of the services that are open in this port, and so on. Also, where we search for a specific host, we obtain information about the host name, the ports that are open, and the service that are available in each port. This information that we see in the web, also we can access with Python in an easy way, but the information for accessing is a little tricky, thus it returns in a dictionary, but it's not directed key value it returns the information in a dictionary, but certain positions have a vector and or array, and you have to play with accessing the information. Finally, we can obtain information, the same information that we have seen in the Shodan web for a specific host. we can obtain this information from Python API. Another easy module that we have in Python is Willwith. Willwith is a very easy module that only have one method, parse, and obtain the information about the frameworks that the website is using and the web servers that is using the website. Well, for metadata, analysis metadata, basically what we can do with Python direct, in an easy way is extract information from metadata from PDFs with the PyPDF2 module. And basically, it's very easy with the pay. What we have to do is create a PDF file reader object, and with the get document info, we obtain the metadata of the PDF. The same we can do with image with a pil.exifstags module, and in an easy way we can decode the tags that are available in an image. For example, we can obtain the GPS info, the data of the image, how is the resolution of the image, and so on. Well, another a little advance future that we can do is port scanning. Port scanning is very new. From the NMAP tool that we can see in Multiplat for operating systems and so on. With Python NMAP, we can launch the NMAP from Python. Basically, what we have is two modes, synchronous and asynchronous. For a synchronous mode, we have to launch the port scanner. We instantiate the NMAP, the object NMAP with port scanner, and we use the scan method where we pass as parameter the IP address and the port, the port listing that we want to scan in this IP. This is an example where we define a class, an NMAP scanner. We initialize the NMAP scanner with calling the port scanner of the NMAP, and with inside the NMAP scan, we go checking the port, calling the scan method, and internally the scan method call the NMAP command that it install in the operating system. And well, we can see information about this is a call example where we pass parameters the target and a port listing, and we can see that the NMAP is executed with default parameters in the port specified and in the IP. And we see and returns if it's open, and also we can access to the if a specific port is open, we can access the version of the service and so on. The other mode that we have with NMAP is asynchronous mode. Asynchronous mode allows launch and scan in a lot of ports simultaneously. And we can define a callback function for when a specific scan in a port is finished, call this function for a for a three-man an additional statement in a specific port. We, for example, in this case, we launch in a specific target with in the 21 port, the FTP port, and we check. Firstly, we have to check if it's open, and if it's open, we can launch a specific process for detecting vulnerabilities in this port specific. For example, in this case, we are testing the FTP port, launching an scripts for checking anonymous FTP login, checking another type of vulnerabilities if the service is vulnerable to a specific backdoor, for example, or specific versions to this service. For checking these vulnerabilities, when we install NMAP. NMAP comes by default with NMAP scripts that are in the master script folder in the install when you install this tool, and have a lot of scripts for checking vulnerabilities in a specific service like FTP, HTTP, and MySQL, for example. Basically, what provides these scripts are routines for finding potential vulnerabilities in a given target. And then the idea, first, we have to check if the port is open, and if the port is open, we can launch the specific scripts for this service. In this case, we are checking that if the MySQL port is open, and if it's open, we are launching scripts like MySQL audit, MySQL brute, MySQL databases. These scripts provide more information about the service and checking, for example, the names, if the database is open, is provides doesn't have any security, for example, or you can see the users without authenticating. This kind of things you can see with launching these scripts. Well, for example, with Shonan, we can check the FTP login anonymous. Basically, with this search, we can check all servers, all machines that allow this type of login without anonymous. The login anonymous, we don't need to provide user and password for accessing the FTP server. For checking this in Python, we have the FTP module that in an easy way we can check if a specific server allows anonymous login. Well, for checking websites, we have another tool called PigWithBooth. PigWithBooth provides resources for checking websites, basically with predictable URLs. That is to say, we have a list of a URL of a URLs, and each URL, each resource. We'll see with an example. For example, we can access in this example we obtain predictable URLs for a specific feature. For example, for login in a website, we get predictable URLs like admin, login, default web page, administrator, and so on. And what you can do is testing for each printable URL, testing this this printable URL over the domain we are testing. And in an easy way, we see that we can check, we make a request over the domain for each predictable URL to see if we can access or not. Many times, there are URLs that we don't see, they are not public, but after testing, after doing this type of testing, we see that there are URLs that are filtered or are not protected, for example, and we can access and navigate and discover other vulnerabilities in the site. Well, the Herbled book is another book that we can testing with in easy way with Python. Herbled is a vulnerability in a specific open SSL version in servers. And this book was discovered in 2014, and well, is a little old, but with this they are if we check this page, Filippo Io Herbled, we see that there are servers, many servers that are also that are vulnerable to this work. Basically, for testing if a specific server has this book, basically what we have to do, we can use the socket module and set a specific request, a specific package, and if the server responds with a specific payload Herbled, the server will be vulnerable to this book. In this case, we can see an example where we launch a testing over a specific machine and returns that this machine is vulnerable to this book. Well, more advanced tool that we can use for integrating with Python, for example, with Metasploit. Metasploit is a very useful tool for sending exploiting vulnerabilities in the servers, in the websites, and so on. And Metasploit can be integrated. It has a module called Python MCFRPC for making calls to Metasploit server from Python. Basically, what we can do is, we have to do is start the server, the service of Metasploit through a plugin. And internally, Metasploit functions like modules for checking, for testing, for exploiting vulnerabilities. In this case, for with Metasploit API call, we can see that with calls in a format specific called MCGPEG pack, we can launch a specific module. In this case, we are using the MQL login for launching, for testing this exploit from Python. Well, and Nexpose, Nexus, and OpenBAS are security analyzers for vulnerabilities and so on. And also we can integrate these tools from Python. For example, it's really easy to integrate from Python. For example, if we have a server with NetSpose where we have vulnerabilities and reports and so on, we can connect with this server from Python using B2 full soup. We can access to this information. The information that returns the server is in XML format, and in an easy way with B2 full soup we can iterate over the vulnerabilities and sites that are deployed in the NetSpose server. Well, I will show now a pen testing tool that this is a quick proof of concept for that has integrated all modules that I have mentioned. Basically, what we can do with pen testing tool is, for example, with a specific machine and a specific port, we can check in if the port is open or not. In this case, we are checking the 2150p port to see the information that returns. In this case, we can see that the port is open, and we can obtain information about the version, specific version of the FTP, the name, and so on. Like the FTP port is open, we can check if the FTP server allows anonymous login. And then if we go to the 13th option, we see that returns that the port 21 is open, and question about if you like to connect with anonymous user. We question yes, and we see that login successful, returns 230, the version of the FTP, the connection is okay, and shows the directory, a listing directory of the server. More things that we can do. If obtain the headers of the server, the headers info, in this case we obtain that we have PHP Ubuntu 5.10. If running an Apache with the version 2.2.8, the version of the PHP, and so on. All this is the headers info. More things that we can do, for example, check if the FTP server has the buffer overflow vulnerability. This is another vulnerability that has a lot of servers, and we can check with this option. First, we check if the port is open. The port is open, and we send a client request to see if the server is vulnerable. We connect to this IP in the port 4444, and we check that the server is vulnerable to this bug. Basically, all this testing are over a virtual machine that I have here in local. This is a virtual machine that has a Linux distribution with a lot of vulnerabilities, and many ports open, and a lot of vulnerabilities relationing with FTP, PHP, Apache server, and so on. This is called a meta-exploitable Linux, if I remember. More things that we can do is check domains and obtain metadata. For example, if the server has information relating with mails, hosts, other servers, or URLs that are exposed in the server, we can check this information. In this case, we see that we are testing the options method that returns the server, and we can obtain the emails that are public in the server, and also we can check, for example, if the server is public, we can check the showdown information that returns. For example, we are using the EuroPython site for checking all the information returned by Shodan service. We launched the tool with the target EuroPython 200 system. It returns the IP address of the domain, and for checking, for example, the host info from Shodan service, we can use the option 6, disconnect to the Shodan service and obtain all polling information. It's time for questions. Okay. Returns all polling information that we have seen. In the presentation, we see that the ports open are the 18, 22, and 25, and returns more information about for each service. Basically, obtain information about the servers, the banners, the version, the versions or the server. For example, the option 10 for scraping image, and in an easy way we can see that extracting of the all the image of the site, and so on. This project is available in my GitHub repository, and it's available for if you want to check the tool, you can do free. In my GitHub repository, also we have a small script for testing each functionality separately from each order. For example, if we want to scan and to launch an NMS scan, we have a specific script for this future. And finally, reference and libs basically are the official pages of the tools that I commented, the Shodan documentation, requests, Python NMAP documentation, and the Python security.org are available, or more libraries that I comment. And it's a very complete site for checking this kind of tools. And finally, books that we can find. This is the main books that we can find for this topic, for pen testing and so on. Thank you.
Any questions?